Lukas. I'm the Education Director at the Spellman Museum of Stamps and Postal History, located on the campus of Regis College in Weston. And this is our monthly show in which we connect stamps with historic events, birthdays of famous people, and other things going on that have a stamp-related theme. Very proud to announce that we started this show in July of 2016, so we're just moving into our third year. And for those who have been watching us for a while, we thank you very much for your viewership. For those new people, just a reminder, a lot of the stamps we are mentioning here on the show can be obtained in copies on our calendar. This features different events for each day. So if you'd like to receive a calendar every month, just email us and our email information is down there at the bottom of the screen. Special event going on at the museum this month. If you see this show before July 20th, we have a special free day going on, sponsored by the Highland Street Foundation. And the museum will be open from 9 to 5, and you're welcome to come in free. We'll have lots of activities for the kids, special exhibits. Since July 20th is the 49th anniversary of the landing of the moon, we will have some special moon exhibits for you to see there. So that's July 20th. Come anytime between 9 and 5. Speaking of the moon landing, the post office has just put out a very nice little kit, mostly kids and adults, and it features a number of the stamps about space that have been issued over the years. Plus, you get some replicas of insignias worn by the different astronauts. So, and plus, they give you a bunch of stamps for your collection. So if you'd like that, the email address or the website address is on the bottom of the screen there, and you can get that. So, July, of course, is always an important month for stamp collectors for two reasons. One, it's the anniversary of the first postage stamps that were issued in the United States. The year was 1847, and England had started issuing stamps a few years earlier, but the United States went ahead in 1847. As you can see the stamps behind me, you have Ben Franklin and George Washington on the two first stamps. The other thing that happened in July, the year was 1963, and that was the initiation of zip code. Many people may not know what zip actually stands for. Very simple, zone improvement plan, and it was aimed to get the mail going faster. So two big anniversaries for postal history in the month of July. We have a couple of exhibits going on at the museum besides the space exhibit. One has to do with the research ship, the Alvin. We have an exhibit of famous women scientists who have gone down in the Alvin, one of them all the way down to the Mariana Trench doing research. And while they were going down, they brought along some envelopes and had them specially canceled. So you'll see some envelopes that have been to the bottom of the ocean, as well as a bunch of stamps featuring some of those strange creatures that these scientists saw. Want to give a little shout out to a museum nearby in Lexington. It's the Museum of the American Heritage, run by the Scottish Rite of the Masons, and they have a nice little exhibit of Civil War envelopes. You can see some examples behind me, and if you get a chance to go out there, we have a book here at the museum, features all the different types of Civil War envelopes. They're big among collectors. And going out there, talking to the nice librarian, I realized that there were a lot of Masons on stamps, and there's a couple of Masons stamps behind me. In fact, their newsletter, the Northern Light, actually every month features about four or five stamps, both the United States and foreign, that feature Masons. So you can pick up that. Every month we do a trivia contest. Last month's trivia contest, they tried to make a connection between a T-shirt issued from the Gap and a philatelic stamp collect connection. We had several people write in. I think I asked the question in a wrong format. What I was looking for was, what was the connection with the wrong map? So the map on the T-shirt was wrong because it was missing the island of Taiwan, and the stamp you see behind me was designed by a Chinese stamp designer, but he made a mistake and didn't color in the island of Taiwan as red. He almost went to jail because of it. The stamp was not sold, but a few of them did get released, and it turns out some of those stamps, the ones that did get out, are very valuable. In fact, one report said one was selling for up to $400,000. So this month's trivia contest, we have two. There's two stamps behind me. One is a 1935 U.S. stamp honoring the exhibition, the world's type of world's fair in San Diego, and the other one is a Shakespeare stamp. And the question we ask you, can you make a connection, history-wise, between the San Diego exhibit and a Shakespeare stamp? And the other little hint, I'll give you a hint on this one, but the question is, when was the last time a stamp was issued first day ceremony at the White House? And give you a couple of hints. It did not have a real person on it, and there was a guest singer at the ceremony. So if you can answer either one of those or both, send us your answer. The connection, philatelic or history connection between Shakespeare and the exhibition in San Diego and that ceremony at the White House. What's that music I hear? Ah, yes, that indicates every month we like to honor our presidents, those both born in the month as well as passed away. And July is always an interesting month for our presidents because two of our founding fathers, Thomas Jefferson and John Adams, both passed away in 1826, and they both did it on that very patriotic day of July 4th. What I didn't know was a third of our presidents, a few years later in 1831, died on July 4th as well, and that was James Monroe. Birthdays on July 4th for presidents, we have two of them. One was Gerald Ford, born in 1913. And a little earlier, Calvin Coolidge was born on July 4th. And you might call him a Yankee Doodle Dandy, which reminded me of a very famous movie called Yankee Doodle Dandy, which starred James Cagney, and you can see a stamp behind him. And that was a movie, kind of a biography of George M. Cohen, the famous writer of many musicals on Broadway. Turns out there's even a statue to Mr. Cohen right in Times Square. A couple of other presidents, Zachary Taylor, unfortunately, died on July 2nd in 1850. And the cause of that, supposedly, he just drank too much ice milk and raw fruit during a big celebration raising money for the Washington Monument. So, unfortunately, a few days later, he passed away from that. Ulysses S. Grant also passed away in July, on the 23rd of July. Possibly he had cancer, which may have been caused by all those cigars that he smoked. And Martin Van Buren and Andrew Johnson both also passed away in the month of July. So, my son was visiting in New Orleans and sent me this picture of the Bob Hope from the World War II Museum in New Orleans, of a coconut that was mailed to Bob Hope. In 1944, according to the museum down there, Bob Hope received about 38,000 letters a week, many of them from troops who may have seen him perform. Well, that Bob Hope coconut reminded me of something our good alligator friend Archie told me. He likes to collect unusual things sent through the mail. And Archie, you got something for us? Oh my goodness, what is this, Archie? This looks like a World War I German helmet. And this actually was sent to the great uncle of a friend of mine, and he decided to donate it to the museum. But it's got the address on it, right, Arch? And it's got the stamps. Point out the stamps there. Yeah. So you can send, just like Bob Hope's coconut, you can send unusual objects in the mail. So what else you got for us, Archie? Ah, here's an interesting envelope. An airmail letter to make it look like a plane. It's kind of fun. Now, if you send letters like this, though, you have to be careful, Arch, right? You got to put extra postage on because this won't go through the regular canceling machine. All right, that's a good thing in your collection. You got something else, Arch? Oh, yeah, Archie got this from a rather a strange stamp collecting friend, right? And he sent him a magazine, and it turns out rather than just put one stamp on it, he decided to add up 3 cent stamps for the total postage. So that's a good collector's item, Archie. And you think you got one more thing for us? Some old Christmas card envelopes. And again, if you be careful there, Arch. And again, if you're old enough to remember when you used to send Christmas cards for 3 cents, you could send them for a penny and a half. But the one thing you didn't do, show them, Arch, here. You didn't seal it. If you didn't seal it, you could send it for half the first class rate. So that was a good deal if you were sending a lot of cards. Well, that's a good collection, Arch. Thanks, and we'll see you next month. Okay, that helmet, by the way, that Archie has there from World War I reminded me that this month the post office is celebrating the 100th anniversary of the end of World War I, with a special stamp featuring a World War I poster. There were hundreds of posters made supporting the war, and the stamp will be coming out, I believe, near the end of July. We'll have to throw in a little nostalgia for some of our folks. They may remember a old TV show called Death Valley Days. Well, we found an episode from 1956 that features a true story about a man named Alex Todd, who was probably the first mailman in California during the gold rush. All the diggers for gold were way out in the countryside and couldn't get to San Francisco to get their mail. So he decided to have a mail service and charged quite a bit, but it was very important for that. So if you'd like to watch that episode, especially if you remember old Death Valley Days, just YouTube Alex Todd, Death Valley Days, and you'll find it. Interestingly, one of our presidents was a host of that show from 1964 to 65, and he actually acted in one of the show, playing a Charles Poston, who was the founder, considered the founder or the father of Arizona. As I mentioned in the previous shows, we have people from students from a stamp club in India who watch our video every month, so we kind of add a little Indian stamp news, and you'll see behind me a stamp issued in honor of Julan Goswami, and she's featured on that stamp for a cricket success. Early in February, she became the first woman cricketer, and I have no idea what this means, to pick 200 wickets in one-day internationals. So if you know anything about cricket, that's quite an accomplishment. Last year, she surpassed the record held by an Australian wicket taker in the women's ODI. So for you cricket fans out there, I think you know Miss Goswami, and maybe you can send us a little note and tell us more about what the cricket news is. We also have a number of our people who watch this show are serious stamp collectors, so we thought we'd let you know of a special stamp that we have in our vault. But this is a stamp that was issued in 1935 related to Amelia Earhart. She had gone down to Mexico to do some publicity, and so the Mexican post office issued a special overprint stamp. They only made so many of them. Some were shipped to other post offices over in Europe, and others went up for sale, and they were put on envelopes. And it turns out we have one of the stamps. You can see a larger picture of it behind me. And these turned out to be quite valuable, and a few years ago, one of them sold for over $2,500. So that's one of the many, many treasures that we have in our vault, and every month we'll be featuring a different one. So... let's see. Just got a little bit more time here, so let me explain a couple of books that we have that you might enjoy. Don't be upset by the title, but what a little messy here. We have a nice book for the kids if you're looking for a nice summer gift. It's called Snail Mail. Don't take offense at the name. We had some people complain about that on another thing we did with snail mail. But it's a good book, and snails actually deliver the mail. So you might take a look at that. It's a new book that just came out. And there's another book all about letter writing called Snail Mail. So we have these at the museum for you to take a look. So hope you have a good July, and we will see you next month. Make sure July 20th, if you're around, please come by for the free program celebrating the anniversary of the landing. Thanks for watching.